Hey everybody, it's the Star Wars Guy here with another video. Today, I want to talk about Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. This is one of my favorite games. It's the only mobile game I've ever been able to consistently stick with. So, I started way back in, right when it came out, I think 2015 maybe. I've been playing ever since. I took one like 7 month period off. And that was a couple years ago. And since then, I've been just rabid. I love the game so much. And it goes through some ups and downs, and it pisses some people off, and they leave or whatever. But I've always been there. I've always loved it. So many new people are starting this game. I figured I'd go back to the very beginning and start completely over and talk you guys through what kind of the best strategies, the best tunes, the best everything is, knowing what I know now. I don't claim to be some sort of insane expert. I'm not the best there is out there. But I have picked up some knowledge along the way, and I figured I'd share that with you guys. So without further ado, let's dive in. So what I've done is I found a emulator for my computer. So I'm going to run it here, and this is the first time I've ever opened this. So I hope it goes well. I mean, this could all go to hell. I'm not going to log into my old account. We're going to start a brand new one here.
Kalehali.
Yeah, here we go.
Durisia Jani, Piatardon, Aipandu Jaimala. Sarni Holotek, Eshpla, Suhutia, Maren Glaka, Eshpra. Volta me!
Gatuka, Nidonina,
this is a mobile game.
Shalora Torsha, Halatas, Awatunku.
Shala Kaiten Jaita Hut. Faisha Kikanji in their high. Kelte Povoktia. Su kisu ayo de jo fajista pe.
Oh, you can't just click. Okay, cool. So I have no idea how to use this software. You guys are, we're learning together. How about that? But I do know the game, so that's what we're here to talk about. Basically, this game is a turn-based strategy game in which you accumulate characters, also called toons, from all across Star Wars into teams of five. You battle other people's teams. Jedi Consular! I'm wondering if the characters that you start with nowadays are the same as when you started back then. That is something that I was thinking about. This guy is. You started with him when I started. And Clone Wars Chewie. Sergeant Phase 1. Haven't played this game in back in the beginning. It's been years. Okay, that worked out. Turn base, so they shoot us, we shoot them. Character has a couple moves, so here you go. Teaching you the bringing back so many awesome memories. I remember playing that when I would eat lunch at Moe's and play this game. All of 2016, basically. Of course, we have to get through all of the basic welcome stuff. But what I primarily wanted to gear this series towards was to talk to you guys about the best way to get the best results the fastest, if that makes sense. It's really cool playing this on a computer. Don't make me buy that for 190 crystals. There he is, one more shooting. First quest, what do we got? Okay, well, I mean, we can do that. Win light side battle 1A. Okay, so you see we have, oh man, Clone Wars Chewie. Looks like he got kicked in the mouth. Seeing all this on a big screen for the first time. Alright. Tapping all of the details. Okay, so this just hurts me. Got it. We're kind of on our own, it looks like. Here we have up here with some things we gotta get through. All right. right? Looks like we're Kashyyyk. Ooh, that got stuff. So with Chewie, we can taunt. First little battle. I'm not sure that it's possible. Now that I say that, watch me lose. The blue bar here is under the health. That's called turn meter. And that determines if when he goes first, so the character speed is faster. That meter fills up. And the more turns you move. So you usually want characters to have a lot of speed. Almost should have killed that commander much earlier, but if you lose any characters, you get less. Player level up 2. So things you might not know at the beginning, there are 85 levels currently at the time of recording this. They are actually talking about increasing that maybe to 90. We'll see how that goes, but... Train Jedi Consular to level 2. I can do that. So you see here, you're about to see all the characters this game has. We can go through them in a second. I can talk about some of the characters that are particularly strong right now. Maybe some of the characters that I have that are pretty strong. So you use training droids to train your Garrett. Anytime you start a game like this, you always progress really quickly in the very beginning. It's like, man, just stop telling me what to do. Let me do my own thing. Here, they're telling you what I told you a minute ago. Blue speed bar, turn meter bar. Now you can. I don't know if that option's available just yet, but. Times 1, which is where we're at now, times 2, or times 4. Those people I know just keep it on times 4. Let's kill these guys. So excited I found a way to share this game with you guys. Because for the longest time I had no idea how I was gonna have it. I also don't get to fully enjoy this game with sound. This is actually all the way through the beginning. And if at any time you guys have any questions about anything, you can always hit me up in the comments section. I'm happy to answer whatever I know. And if I don't know, I definitely have guildmates that do know, and I can ask them for you. All right. Oh, we get a free character at player level 4. Please enter your age. I'm 100. Sign into Google Play. Okay, so made my account, logged in. Star Wars guy. Awesome. Here we go. This is a new thing they added right here. Special offer. Check this out. They call it the Hyperdrive Bundle. So for $100, you can jump all the way up to player level 85. Upgrade up to 65 characters, 16 ships, gear and resources, all this stuff. It'll tell you everything you get. So that's something to think about if you're taking it seriously. Obviously, we're not going to do that, because I'm going to go through and show you everything as we go. So you can go the free-to-play route like I did. Objectives, let's see. Quests. Win Lightside Battle 1C. Increase character level once. We can do that. Equip gear once. Yeah, we haven't talked about gear, have we? This is super important. This is called the Journey Guide. So this is going to tell you how to get some of the strongest characters in the game. So here you go. Tap on the title of Grandmaster Yoda, one more. You found a piece of gear. 6 pieces of gear, and we can open the gear level. Yep, cool. Did it. Awesome. So, let's talk about gear. My Jedi Consular's gear level 1. If I get 6 pieces of gear on him, he's going to be able to go up to gear level 2. Now, there are currently 13 gear levels, and they get progressively harder to get to each time. So, what do we know so far? 85 levels, so the highest level your characters can be is level 85. Let's get them all to level 2. 13 gear levels. Yeah, Chewbacca's face is messed up, man. Mouth of a steel bar. I personally try to keep everyone kind of an equal level in the beginning. Obviously, this team of Clone Wars Chewbacca, Clone Sergeant, and Jedi Consort is not a particularly strong team by any means, with not a lot of synergy. That's all right. It doesn't really matter. All right, let's take a look at the characters we have here. If you go here, we can sort by favorites. You can add favorites. Who's an actual leader with a leader ability, meaning they have an ability that will affect all 4 other people on your team. Who you have unlocked, who you don't, light side, dark side, neutral, and then you have all these different factions. Check out how deep this game goes. This is why I love it. I mean, look how many Old Republic tunes there are. If you ever played Knights of the Old Republic, you'll appreciate this. And Jedi Knight Revan is, I mean, one of the best characters in the game. Sith Empire, Darth Revan probably is the best character in the game. Darth Malak as well. These two together, you're not going to have them for a while, but the two of them together, at least right now in the meta, almost unbeatable. Let's see what it takes to unlock a character. So you see this 030, 015, 015, all that stuff. Those are called shards. You get shards by completing these missions, and they'll give you shards. So then once you complete them, you can go back and do what they call sim them, which means you don't have to actually play them again. You can auto-play them to get shards. Collect 15 shards, and our Jedi Consular goes from 1 star to 2 stars. And all the way up to 7 stars is the top you can get. Do we have anyone with a leader ability yet? We do! Chewie has a leader ability. So all of our allies are going to have plus 10 defense if we put Chewie in the leader slot. Let's do another battle. And then that might wrap up the introduction to this game. Ah, here's what I was telling you. We have 2 and 4. And we can actually go on auto. These are... Pros and cons of that. It goes by really fast, and you don't have to think about it on simple battles like these. I do actually most of my battles on auto. This is something I'm really focused on trying to do in a specific way. Or if auto has failed numerous times. So there you go. That'll do it for the first video in this series. We are starting Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes from the very beginning, and I'm going to walk you through the best tactics, strategies, and options for you so you can get all the way up to the top as fast as possible. So thanks so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe for more Star Wars content, and I will see you guys soon.